guys, I'm Sushmita from Miss Pink Shoes and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be doing a makeup tutorial on this look right here, which is inspired and for Navratri. So Navratri is one of my favorite festivals because I love just dressing up and dancing. I love dancing. Although last year I didn't get to attend Navratri because I wasn't well and I had too much work and I also had some exams going on. But this time I'm really excited for the Navratri season because I just can't wait to dance. So yes, I'm going to be doing a makeup tutorial on this look right here and I'm also going to tell you guys how you can customize it according to your outfit so you don't wear the same look every single time you're going out. You can totally play around and I'm just really happy with the way this turned out. So yes, if you'd like to know how to get this look, then please keep on watching. Alright, so this is the condition of my face. I'm feeling really dead, but it's time to zhuzh this face up. So I'm going to start off by priming and today I'm going to be using the Maybelline New Baby Skin Instant Pore Eraser Primer. I love this to bits. This makes my pores just disappear. I don't know how it does that and it just makes my makeup last so much longer. So when you're going for an event like Navratri, you really want something that will stick your makeup onto your face so you have it on all night despite of all the dancing and sweating and all of that. Next step is color correcting because Lord knows I need it. So I'm going to be using the LA Girl Pro Concealer. This is in the shade Orange Corrector. So I'm first taking out onto my under eyes and my lids and also to all the other areas where I have pigmentation, which is pretty much half my face. So my pigmentation has gotten a lot worse over the last 2 months and I'm working on it. But yes, until then, we have a concealer to help us out. I literally look like an Adivasi right now. So before you guys start judging me, I'm gonna start blending this out. Moving on to foundation, now you want to pick a foundation that really lasts on your face and does not make your skin oily or too dry depending on what your skin is. And my go-to foundation lately has been the L'Oreal Matte Magique. I've been obsessed with this. This is in the shade G3 and this just works so well, guys. Like, this just stays put onto my face for such a long time. So first, I'm just dotting it all over my face with my beauty blender and also down my neck directly. And now I'm just going to start blending this out. So this does oxidize a tad bit onto my face. So yeah, it might look light for me, but in a bit, it's just going to be well settled in. And look at the coverage this is giving me. It's beautiful and it feels like I have nothing on. It's super lightweight and it stays put on my face like for the whole day. And just to make things a tad bit easier, I'm going to take this PAC Masterstrokes brush and I'm going to use that around my neck and also below my chin here. I'm taking just a tad bit extra onto my cheeks and my under eye. So lately I've barely been using any concealer and I don't know why, I'm just liking my foundation so much better right now. Now I'm going to take the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Contouring and Highlighting Palette and I'm going to contour and highlight my face. So I'm not going too heavy with contouring because I want it to be a really nice natural kind of a look. So I'm concentrating first on setting my under eye with the highlighter. Then on my nose, forehead, cupid's bow, chin and below my contour, which already makes it look like I've contoured my cheeks. And now it's time to carve out those cheekbones. I'm taking some of the contour powder onto my cheeks, my jawline, forehead and either sides of my nose. And I'm just blending everything out one by one. So first blending out the nose. And then going back in with this pack brush, I'm going to blend out my contour. And the reason why I'm doing this is because I don't want my contour to be really stuck. I want it to be blended out like a bronzer. And this will help me in getting a really nice soft blend. So yes, that's exactly what I'm doing. So you guys know I always run away from blush, but on Indian looks, I love wearing blushes. So today I'm going to be taking the NARS blush in the shade Orgasm. And I look like Chutki from Chota Bheem. Don't worry, I'm not going to let it be like this. And now with the PAC Masterstrokes brush, I'm just going to blend this out to get like a really nice, soft, natural blend. Going in with another layer. So whenever I have events like these, or I know where I'm going to be doing a lot and my makeup is going to move, what I like to do is set down a liquid highlighter base and then put on my powder so that I'm highlighting all night long no matter what. So I'm going to first take the Master Strobing Stick by Maybelline. This is in the shade Nude and I have been loving this so much. I can't even tell you guys. So first I'm taking this over my cheekbones, tip of my nose, Cupid's bow, below my brow bone, tap it on my forehead and my chin. So I'm first blending it out with this Master Stroke brush again. And you guys can already see how beautiful this glow is. And this actually lasts, like I'm not even joking. But being the person that I am, I want a little extra. So I'm going to take the PAC Baked Highlighter in the shade 04 and go over top of this. I feel like I'm living. I'm loving this. Now moving on to the brows. So since I want my brows to not move out of place at all, I'm going to be taking the Freedom Eyebrow Pomade in the shade Ash Brow. And I'm going to pick this product up to fill in my brows. So I've purposely extended my brows a little extra because with an Indian look, I really like longer brows. So that's why I've done it and I'm loving the way this turned out. So moving on to the eyeshadow now. So today I'm going to be doing like a really nice cool toned blue eye makeup. So what I would like to say is blue and green is something that goes with a lot of Navratri outfits. So you can totally switch this blue for a green or any other color that's there in your outfit. So this is like a very multi-use kind of a look where you can just switch the color in the corners that I'm going to be applying into any color that's there in your outfit to match it to yours. So that's why I decided to do this, so that you guys can easily replicate it in your own way. So I'm starting off by taking the Blush Nudes palette by Maybelline and I'm going to pick up this gray color right here and I'm taking this to my transition. So if you're using a color like red, yellow, orange, go ahead and use like an orange or a brown transition. But if you're using cool tones like blues, greens, pink, you can totally use a gray transition. And now I'm dipping into this eyeshadow palette by Miss Claire, which has this beautiful blue color. So I'm just going to pick that up. And what I'm going to do is try and mix it with the transition so it does not look patchy. And I'm slightly smoking it outward to make it look like a slight wink, not too much. The next step is something that you can decide according to your outfit. So if your outfit has a lot of gold, you can use a gold. If it has a lot of silver, you can use silver. But my outfit has like a golden silver border and I'm wearing silver jewelry. So I'm going to take the highlighter that I use, which is like a nice champagne toned highlighter. So it would go with my outfit. You can totally use your highlighter for this. You don't need an eyeshadow. But if you have a pretty eyeshadow, you can go ahead and use that. So I'm just applying it to the beginning half of my eye to make it look really clean and sparkly. Now again, I'm going to take a bit of that blue on a small pencil brush and just intensify it in the corner so it looks a little more popping. So that's how simple it was, guys. Choose the color from your outfit and put it on the outer corner, and the color on the inside can be the work or the color scheme of your outfit and you're sorted. So when I'm doing Indian looks, I really like wearing a nice kajal. So today I'm going to be using the Nykaa I Am Black. This is the only one that I trust will last all day long. So I'm just going to apply it to my eye, but I'm leaving the beginning 1/4 empty and I'll tell you guys why in just a bit. And I'm also tight lining my eyes with the same. So I'm taking my highlighter and applying it on the beginning 1/4 that I left empty. And I'm doing this because it will just make my eyes look a little more opened up. So when you leave the beginning 1/4 of your eye and apply like a white or a nude or anything very highlighty which will get attention, it will just make your eyes look a lot more opened up and bigger. Okay, now I'm just super tempted to use some glitter. You don't have to do this, but I'm just really tempted. So I'm just going to take this glitter by half and half. It's a pure gold glitter. I love it. And I'm going to place it on the beginning 1/4 of my eye to just zhuzh it up a little. Okay, now I'm going to take the Lakme Absolute Shine line and make like a regular winged liner. So to finish my eye, I'm going to take the False Lash Superstar Mascara by L'Oreal. And I'm first going to take the primer side of it to apply a nice thick coat on my lashes. And now I'm going to go in with the black portion of the mascara and coat my lashes. So I like to apply the primer just on my upper lashes and not on my lower lashes. Otherwise, my lower lashes look a little weird and clumpy. So yes, I just applied the primer to my upper lashes. Now taking this down to my lower lashes. So now moving on to the lips. So generally for an event like this, I would definitely wear a liquid lipstick. But my lips are feeling a little chapped today. So I'm going to use something creamy so it's comfortable. So I'm going to be taking the Lakme 95 Creaseless Lip Color. This is in the shade Scarlet Drill. And now to finish the look, I'm going to add a bindi in the color of my outfit. So yeah, this one works. I'm also adding a nose pin. And now to make sure this look looks as Gujarati as possible, I'm going to take my eyeliner and make 3 dots on my chin. And I'm just going to add 2 dots along the lines of my wing. Okay, now seriously, the final step, I'm going to take some highlighter and I'm going to pop out my fake cheekbones and I'm just going to highlight them because when you're dancing, it would just look really pretty. So yeah, I'm just doing that. So that's it for this video, guys. I really hope you guys liked this look. And if you did, don't forget to comment down below and let me know and give this video a big thumbs up. Also, subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos from me and I'll see you soon in my next video. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Bye.